The politics lead now. Democrats say they are following the money, and they're now demanding answers from Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin about his past ties to a major shareholder in a Russian firm that was sanctioned by the U.S. until recently. The questions zero in on Mnuchin's connections to a major Republican donor who benefited from the Trump administration's decision to lift sanctions on firms with ties to Russian oligarch Oleg Deripaska. Should Mnuchin have recused himself from overseeing the lifting of these sanctions? As CNN's Sunlen Serfaty reports, Mnuchin did not recuse himself, and that is setting off some ethical alarms.
Democrats on Capitol Hill are ratcheting up pressure on Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, zeroing in on his own alleged ties to Russia after the Treasury Department formally eased sanctions on Russian companies this weekend.
The conflict of interest is there.
Mnuchin hit with four letters in one day from Democrats in the House and Senate, raising what they call alarming potential conflicts of interest regarding that decision. At issue, whether Mnuchin has a connection to the Russian billionaire Oleg Deripaska, who has close ties to Vladimir Putin. The U.S. had sanctioned Deripaska's companies last year in a move to punish the Kremlin for interfering in the 2016 presidential election. Among those companies with sanctions now lifted by Mnuchin, Rusal, an aluminum manufacturer whose shareholders include a deep-pocketed American Republican donor, Len Blavatnik, who Mnuchin has a personal history with, reportedly investing in Mnuchin's film company and even hosting Mnuchin on his yacht, according to the letters.
This suggests to me that there was never an intention to impose sanctions on these companies or on Deripaska. It was done because the pressure got very hot and the administration had taken no action on the legislation passed by Congress.
So you think they're, in essence, feigning these sanctions?
Yes.
Democrats writing to Mnuchin demanding an explanation as to how you manage your own potential conflicts of interest arising from your personal and professional relationship with Blavatnik. The Treasury Department firing back, calling the Democrats' suggestion of conflict of interest baseless, saying Mnuchin had no direct business relationship with Mr. Blavatnik. It's not the first time the multimillionaire with deep ties to Hollywood has raised eyebrows. Mnuchin was cleared of wrongdoing after taking a military plane to Kentucky during the solar eclipse. Famously posed with his wife at the Mint with dollar bills bearing his signature. All this as Mnuchin is still putting off calls to testify on Capitol Hill, one of three cabinet secretaries to do so lately.
It begs the question, what are they trying to hide? But they can only do that for so long because Congress has subpoena power and they will be subpoenaed.
And Democrats on Capitol Hill tell me this increased attention on Steve Mnuchin is just another indication on how they intend to hold the administration's feet to the fire, so to speak, up here on Capitol Hill, Jake, especially, of course, with their newfound power in the House.